In this video, I'm gonna show you some recipes with using kabocha squash. I'm gonna first of all show you a salad bowl, like a roasted kabocha squash salad, and then also a roasted kabocha squash pasta sauce. So for the roasted kabocha squash salad, I'm just taking my kabocha squash and I'm just gonna roast it up in the oven at like 220 Celsius for around 40 minutes, I would say, just using some olive oil, a little bit of dried oregano and some salt and pepper. And then for my salad, I'm using some red onion, some cucumber, lime juice, some fresh parsley, and just a ton of cabbage in there also, red cabbage. And I'm also just gonna throw in one can of chickpeas to add some more like carbs and like some like fillingness to the salad. So mix that around, and I'm just gonna top that off with my roasted kabocha squash. And then I'm gonna top everything off with this tahini dressing. I'm gonna put the recipe in the description if you want the recipe, but it's basically like a tahini maple syrup recipe that was really, really good on this. It kind of, the maple syrup contrast with the squash is kind of like a really good combo, I feel like. But yeah, I'm gonna also put the macros on the screen, and as you can see right here, I was very satisfied with the result. So for the next recipe, I'm gonna try to make like a kabocha squash pasta sauce. I've never really made this before, so this is like a first time experience. But I basically just took 3 cups of kabocha and mixed it with some olive oil, some salt, pepper, a little bit of garlic powder. Put it in the oven for like 45 minutes at 230 Celsius. And then I just took the roasted squash and I put it in like a blender, mixed it with 1/4 cup of almond milk, until it basically looks like kind of like baby food. It's actually kind of what it comes out looking like, as you can see. But I just mixed it all up. Definitely use a larger blender than I did, so you don't have to do it in 2 batches. But you know, I just had to do that because I only have this little hand mixer thing. And I just added it to a pan along with some of the pasta water, probably like 1/4 cup of the pasta water, because it's kind of like starchy. It's gonna help kind of make it into like a sauce. And then I also just gradually added some like more almond milk to the pan to kind of loosen it up, make it more liquid, make it more like a sauce. So that's the finished product of my first time experience with making kabocha squash pasta sauce. It turned out really good, like it tastes really good, but next time I'm definitely gonna add more almond milk. I think maybe use, if you're gonna make this, maybe use 1/2 cup of almond milk instead of 1/4 cup, because it definitely needed some more like saucy consistency. It ended up kind of being just like mashed kabocha squash mixed with pasta. It was like definitely a little bit too thick. But other than that, definitely try this recipe. Definitely try both of these recipes. And I hope you enjoyed this video. And I'm going to see you in the next video. And yeah, go make some kabocha squash. Or again, you can use any type of squash, like butternut squash. Or any type of squash you have. Freaky like the red leather Michael. Zombie revival. This ain't like you.